Hey, everybody, give Ms. Renning a hand. Let's go. She is the one that fixed our printer. Give her another applause. Holy moly.
This is Grads Talkin' Shop. My name is G. Bundy, and I'm a teacher. That's me, and that's the Future Bus. We talk to former Beaverton students, and we learn about their career paths. Since they've left high school, they've been on their own journey, and they're all a little different. We listen to their stories so we can learn from their experiences. Today, we are heading out to Vigor Industrial in Portland to meet with Westview alum Tanner Scott.
Hi, my name's Tanner Scott. I'm the welding supervisor at Vigor Fab, and I also teach part-time for Portland Community College.
So you work during the day, and by night you're a teacher. Maybe just walk us through, what do you do? What do you do here?
At Vigor Fab, I'm the welding supervisor. So I take care of all of our welding equipment, all of our procedures, and then in the evening, come over here and teach part-time for PCC.
I read on your website that 50% of things manufactured in the U.S. require welding.
Mm-hmm.
To someone who doesn't know what it is, what would you say it is?
Welding's basically joining two pieces of metal together. We take an electrode and a lot of electricity, and you melt the electrode and the two pieces of metal together to build structures.
So when you say projects, there's a lot of different types of projects here that you're involved in. Mm-hmm. Can you? I know some of them we can't talk about, especially
yeah.
That amazing thing that I saw today. I can't even
yep.
tell people what it is, but it was cool. But what are the types of things that you...
Yeah, so we're a complex fab shop. So we work everything from nuclear, aerospace. We do a lot of bridge work as well. So one of the projects right now is Golden Gate Bridge, doing mm-hmm. a retrofit for that.
Can you tell us a little bit about, I know we can't see it, but can you tell us what you're making for them?
For Golden Gate?
Yeah.
It's suicide prevention. So we're basically creating capture nets on the side, redoing a bunch of handrail, and then adding a bunch of safety features for maintenance as well.
We learned that you went to Westview,
mm-hmm.
and you did a little bit of work there with a teacher in engineering, welding.
Yeah, so I took classes from Coach K. Took shop classes from him, and I absolutely loved it. Mm-hmm. That was, yeah, by far my favorite class. Got to be hands-on. He was very good with instructing us and leading us towards developing our skills.
Let's pump the brakes for a second. Tanner took CTE classes at Westview from Furl Kamakala, also known as Coach K. CTE stands for Career Technical Education. Great. But what does that mean? In Tanner's case, it meant learning about welding, 3D design, and lots of other manufacturing techniques. Let's check it out.
Remember I talked to you guys about careers in CTE, career technical training, and college-bound, non-college-bound opportunities. We are in a CTE manufacturing. The jobs that you can get on taking stuff in this class, you don't have to go to college to get a four-year degree. You can go straight from high school to training to work and get a good paying job. Whoa. Everybody up, let's go. Our morning exercise, let's go. The hokey pokey.
Oh no.
Neil, come on, Neil. Krishna, you can stand right here too. Okay, come here. So we're talking about, right? We're talking about communication and communication skills. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Everybody, ask the class.
Are you guys ready?
All right. You put your right foot in. You put your...
I majored in math and minored in secondary education, and 3 years into college, I just decided that, you know, teaching high school math wasn't for me anymore.
Yeah.
I was taking welding classes during the summer when I came home from school, and absolutely loved it. Basically saw like the amount of money I can make as a teacher compared to how much I can make as a welder.
I don't want to.
It wasn't even comparable.
Don't tell me that number. And next question.
Yeah. It's a lot of hours. It's hard work, but it is so rewarding. For me, I was going 4 year college. That's the path I had to take, but I didn't know what I wanted to do with it. So I kind of chose something that wasn't perfect for me and it ended up not working out. So really be open to different possibilities and look into different options.
When I went out with you the other day, we were walking and we saw some massive ships. Do you ever get tired of seeing giant ships? Like, is it still cool? Because it's really freaking cool to me.
So first time I came down to the shipyard was my dad, and I was probably about 12 years old, and we were able to walk down there and see the inserts that the Boilermakers down here were doing. And I was just in awe with how big these vessels are.
Sorry, we're trying to film.
Oh! Hey! How's it going?
Key, how's it going?
Not bad.
What do you got here? What a crazy coincidence. How are you?
What are you doing all the way over here?
We told Furl that we were coming down, and he was the one who connected us with you. I told him we were coming down and that we would love to get him to come down and just hang out with us, even if it was for 5 minutes.
No matter what high school you go to, there is a CTE program available to you. Find one that interests you by talking to your counselor or by visiting our website.
Never had.